the Solvay process. The Solvay process is one of the processes that is used to manufacture sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate can be manufactured from trona. That is the easiest way of manufacturing sodium carbonate. When you are in a place that there is no trona, then you can manufacture sodium carbonate using the Solvay process. Now, first of all, what are the uses of sodium carbonate? What are the uses of sodium carbonate? Now, sodium carbonate is used in softening water. It is also used in paper industry. Sodium carbonate is also used in glass industry. Another use of sodium carbonate is that it is used to make sodium silicate. Sodium silicate. And this sodium silicate glass is used in making detergents. Another use of sodium carbonate is that sodium carbonate is used in manufacturing of baking powder, which is very common in the houses. Baking powder. And apart from that, there is also sodium hydrogen carbonate. This one is sodium hydrogen carbonate. Sodium hydrogen carbonate is also used to make that is baking powder and health drinks. It is also used in health drinks. Now, because we now know the uses of sodium carbonate, it is now important that we learn the process, the Solvay process, the process that is used to manufacture or to make sodium carbonate. And this process usually takes place in stages. And we have four main components in the manufacture of sodium carbonate. You can call these towers. There are four, we have four main towers when we are manufacturing sodium carbonate. The first one is called the Solvay tower. This one is called the Solvay tower, also called fast absorption chamber. The second one is called ammonia generator. This one is called ammonia generator. The other one is called the second absorption tower. Second absorption tower. And this second absorption tower is also called carbonator. It's also called carbonator. Very good. This one, the fourth one, is called limestone kiln or calcium carbonate kiln. Limestone kiln or calcium carbonate kiln. Between the limestone kiln and the second absorption tower, we have what we call the filter. We have a filter here, and at the bottom of the filter we have another structure that we call a roaster. This is a roaster. And then between the Solvay tower and the ammonia generator, here we have what we call ammonia source. We have ammonia source. So these are the main components of the Solvay process. Now in this Solvay process, the raw materials of the Solvay process, raw materials means the fundamental materials that are required for this process to take place. Raw materials means the fundamental materials that are required for this process to take place. And these ones are, one is ammonia, is a raw material. And Another one, raw material is limestone. Another raw material is cork. And another one is water, brine. Another one is brine. And the brine is concentrated sodium chloride. Brine is concentrated sodium chloride. So these are the raw materials, the ones that are required for this process to take place. Now, what happens first is that brine or concentrated sodium chloride is fed into the Solvay tower. And ammonia is fed down from there. This ammonia comes from ammonia source. Brine is fed there, ammonia mixed with water is fed at the bottom. And then you have a mixture from there. You have a mixture that is called ammonical brine, which goes to the second absorption tower. This mixture of sodium chloride, that is brine, and ammonia is called ammonical brine. Ammonical brine. It is also called, this mixture, sometimes it is called ammoniated brine. Ammoniated brine. Or you can say it is brine mixed with ammonia. So basically what you are having here is ammonia and sodium chloride and water. That mixture, ammonical brine, ammonia, sodium chloride, and water. This one goes to the second absorption tower. Now what happens at the second absorption tower is that this ammonical brine or mixture of brine with ammonia is reacted with carbon 4 oxide, CO2. And this carbon 4 oxide comes from the limestone kiln. Carbon 4 oxide comes from the limestone kiln. And where do we get this carbon 4 oxide? At the limestone kiln, that is why it is called limestone kiln, we have limestone is heated, and limestone is basically calcium carbonate. This limestone is heated. When you heat limestone, you get calcium oxide plus carbon 4 oxide gas. When you heat limestone, you get calcium oxide plus carbon 4 oxide gas. So this carbon 4 oxide that has been produced here is the one that is taken to the second absorption tower. And also at the limestone kiln, apart from heating limestone, we also heat cork, and cork is carbon. When carbon is heated in oxygen, this one also produces carbon 4 oxide gas. So at the kiln, carbon 4 oxide is achieved. Carbon 4 oxide is formed by thermal decomposition of limestone, that is calcium carbonate, and also combustion of carbon, that is cork, produces carbon 4 oxide. Now the reaction at the second absorption tower, the reaction that takes place, second absorption tower, is this. This reaction takes place in two steps. First of all, ammonia will react with water and carbon 4 oxide to produce ammonium hydrogen carbonate. This one produces ammonium hydrogen carbonate. Ammonia reacts with water and carbon 4 oxide to produce ammonium hydrogen carbonate. Remember, it was ammonical brine, a mixture of ammonia and sodium chloride. So the second step is the sodium chloride, that is the brine, reacts with ammonium hydrogen carbonate to give sodium hydrogen carbonate and ammonium chloride. And the overall step, when you add these two equations, you can see we can cancel this ammonia and hydrogen carbonate both sides. We'll have ammonia gas reacting with water, carbon four oxide gas, and sodium chloride, that is brine, to give us sodium hydrogen carbonate and ammonium chloride. Sodium hydrogen carbonate and ammonium chloride. Now, at the second absorption tower, that is the carbonator, the ammonium chloride is going to form crystals. Ammonium chloride is going to form crystals at the cooler ends of the carbonator. Now, all these two are salts, and these two salts must be separated, because remember that in this process, what we want is sodium carbonate. Solvay process, the function of sodium, Solvay process is to give us sodium carbonate. So these two products that have been produced at the carbonator, that is, we have two products, the ammonium chloride and the sodium hydrogen carbonate, will be taken to the filter. At the filter will separate, because the two salts are not, the solubility is different, the filter will separate sodium hydrogen carbonate, and this sodium hydrogen carbonate will be taken to the roaster. And ammonium chloride will be taken to the ammonia generator. Ammonium chloride will be taken to the ammonia generator. At the roaster is very important. At the roaster, we heat sodium hydrogen carbonate, is heated. At the roaster, sodium hydrogen carbonate is heated, action of heat on salts, remember, to give sodium carbonate, plus carbon four oxide, plus water. That is the reaction that takes place at the roaster. Now this sodium carbonate is the one that is required in the Solvay process. So this one will go for grinding and storage and packing. Grinding, storage, or packing, ready for sale. The water that has been produced in this process will be used somewhere else. And that is what we are going to talk about. This water that has been formed here will be used somewhere else. We say that in the limestone kiln, we produce carbon 4 oxide and calcium oxide. This calcium oxide, what will happen, we have water that comes from another source, and this water is going to be supplemented with the water that comes from the roaster. So in this process, we have matters or materials that are recycled. And one of the recycled materials is water, as we have seen there. We are recycling water. And from the kiln, we have also seen that we are recycling carbon four oxide. So those two materials are recycled. They are produced in the process, and then they are reused. They are used again. So this water, plus water from another source, will be added to calcium oxide, and this is what is called slaking. Slaking means adding water to calcium oxide to form what? These two are going to give us what we call calcium hydroxide. I hope you're following. These two will give us calcium hydroxide. Now this calcium hydroxide that has been formed here will be also be taken to the ammonia generator. This calcium hydroxide that has been formed is going to be taken to the ammonia generator. At the ammonia generator, the reaction that takes place at the ammonia generator. This is the reaction, ammonia generator. The reaction that takes place is that calcium hydroxide reacts with ammonium chloride. Remember that we took ammonium chloride there, and we're also taking calcium hydroxide there to form calcium chloride. And ammonia gas and water. Those are the three products in the ammonia generator. This ammonia will be taken to the Solvay tower or fast absorption tower. And the calcium chloride formed does not have any use. So calcium chloride is going to be taken for other processes. It has uses in other fields. Ammonia and water will be taken to the Solvay tower. So we can see ammonia is also recycled. Another thing that is recycled is ammonia. Now basically this is the process, the Solvay process, the way it is from the beginning to the end. And this kind of a, because this one is a plant, it is a process, this kind of a plant is supposed to be situated in a place that has good supply of water, because the process produces a lot of heat, and once in a while you need cooling. So water is a very good material for cooling, and it is required in this Solvay process. Another thing is that we have already discussed the uses of sodium carbonate. We have said it is used in various processes like making baking powder and so on and so forth. And at this point, I think if you have any questions, class, you can ask from the beginning of the process to the end. I think I'm done with the processes. If you have any question, you can ask. If you don't have a question, maybe there's something else I'm just going to mention. Such processes produce carbon 4 oxide, and carbon 4 oxide is a pollutant. And because it is a pollutant, how it is a pollutant, carbon 4 oxide is a gas that is called a greenhouse gas. And these greenhouse gases, they cause global warming. And when global warming occurs, what happens is that the ice at the polar ice is going to melt. When the polar ice melts, what happens? The sea levels are going to rise. And when sea levels rise, it also leads to erratic weather conditions. Erratic weather conditions means conditions of weather that are unpredictable. Unpredictable weather conditions. These ones are what we call erratic weather conditions. Apart from that, we also have another compound of carbon that also causes pollution, and this is carbon 2 oxide. Carbon 2 oxide is produced when carbon is burnt, or combustion of carbon in limited oxygen or insufficient amount of oxygen. And carbon 2 oxide, if it is breathed in, it mixes with hemoglobin to form a stable compound that is called carboxyhemoglobin. Now this carboxyhemoglobin, when it is in the blood, it reduces or it minimizes the capacity of the blood to carry out oxygen. And because of that, this one can lead to suffocation. We are going to talk more about that, pollution effects of carbon 2 oxide and carbon 4 oxide. I think I'm done. If there's any question you can ask, that is the end of our discussion today.